Chapter Socialism in Europe and Russian Revolutions. In the previous video, we discussed about the ideology that spread over Europe were the radicals, the liberals, and the conservatives. The liberal, as they wanted some changes in the structure of the society, where radicals believed in changes, and the conservatives with no changes in the society. By the 19th century, some changes was inevitable, but they believed that the past should be respected. Change had to be brought through slow process. So here you see industrial society and the social changes. So this is the time of the industrial revolutions, and what were the changes occurred in the society. So this political trend was a sign of a new time. It was a time of great change in the social and the political conditions of the states. So it was a time when the new cities came up and the new industrialist big regions developed, railway expanded, and the industrial revolution began. As you know, industrial revolution which began in the 18th century when agricultural societies became more industrialized and urban. So what were the conditions of the people? So industrialization, you can see, brought both the men, the women, and the children to the factories. If you talk about the works hours were often long and the wages were very low. And if unemployment was common, particularly during the times of low demand for industrial goods. And when we talk about the housing and the sanitation was problem since towns were rapidly growing. And you can see here that the liberals and the radicals searched for solution to these issues. Now here comes the capitalist. So who are the capitalists? So you can see almost all the industries were the property of individual. This means the production was largely or entirely privately owned by the individual or companies and operated only to earn profit. So the liberals and radicals were often there were property owners and employers having made their wealth through trades or industrial ventures. So they felt that such efforts should be increased, that it should benefit, its benefit would be achieved if the workforce were healthy and citizens were educated. They opposed to the old aristocracy. Aristocracy is the divine rule of the king. Had by birth, it means that the son of the king will become the king. That firmly believed in the value of individual efforts, labors, and enterprises. So they believed was the freedom. When we talk about the belief that the freedom of individual is ensured, and if the poor could labor and the capitalist could operate without restraint, they believed that the society would develop. So many working class, if we talk of the men and the women who wanted changes in the world, rallied around liberals and radical groups and the party in the early 19th century. Some nationalists, liberals and radicals wanted revolution to put an end to the kind of the government established in Europe in 1815. In France, in Italy, in Germany and Russia, they became revolutionaries to overthrow existing monarch. Nationalists talk of revolution thus would create nations where all citizens would have equal right. So here comes the coming of socialism to Europe. The political, when we talk of the socialism, it's a political idea that is based on the belief that all people are equal and that money and property should be equally divided. Okay, by the mid 19th century in Europe, you can see socialism was a well-known body of idea and attracted widespread attention. Socialists who practiced socialism were against of private properties. Why they were against of private property? As they saw it as the social evils of the time. So what was the so here if we talk about this, that the individuals who owned property that gave employment to other also, but the property owner is concerned only with his personal interest or profit, but not with the welfare of his employees who made his property protective. So if you can see, instead of the single individual control, it talk about that the property should be under the control of the society, so that the more attention would be paid to the collective social interest. They wanted this change and campaigned for it. So how could a society without property operate? So socialists had different vision of the futures. Here you can see, once they talk about the cooperative society, another is the communalism. Okay, so when we talk about Robert Owen, you can see Owen, a leading English manufacturer, sought to build a cooperative community called New Harmony in Indiana, USA. And other socialists felt that the cooperatives could not be built on wide scale only through the individuals, but individual initiatives. Okay, that instead of individual, government encourage cooperative and replace capitalist. So cooperative here is the associations of the people. Okay, who produce good together and then they divide the profit according to the work done by the members. So here comes the communalism. You can see Karl Marx and Friedrich Engels, they added their own view. Marx argued that the industrial society was a capitalist society. So capitalists are the owner, they own the capital. Capital here is the wealth in the form of money and other assets. It was owned by the persons or the organization. The profit of the capitalist was produced by workers. But as the owner of the enterprises or industry, the property will accumulated by the private capitalist. In case the condition of the worker cannot be improved, or they will be in the mercy of the capitalist. So Marx believed that to free themselves from capitalist exploitation, worker had to construct a radical social, you can see radical socialist society. So where all the property was socially controlled. So here comes, this would be the communist society. So what is the communalism? Here you can see property is owned by the community and each person contribute and receive according to their ability. So Marx was convinced that the worker would win the conflict against the capitalist. According to him, the future of the society would be the communist society. So here we saw the socialism in Europe, which is based on cooperative and communalism.